Welcome to Course Navigation. As you enter a course, remember to keep in mind what changes and what stays the same. The sooner you become more technically proficient at navigating Momentum, the sooner you can begin your learning journey as an online learner. Now let's see what happens as we enter our first course. You'll notice that a few things change and some things remain the same. There are three changes that we notice as we first log in. The first item is the section entitled News. The News section is where instructors post various updates and information about the course. The second item is a calendar section. The calendar keeps a running log of important dates throughout the duration of your course. As instructors add material and or graded assignments with specific due dates, these dates will postulate within the calendar and create a list of upcoming events. The third and most important section is a new navigation bar in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. You'll first notice that the new navigation bar is broken into three categories: materials, communication, and assessments. These categories are organized in this way so that you can more quickly find and use what you need while you're in class. Materials contains all the elements of the course that are static or purely informational. Under materials, you will find calendar, checklist, content, frequently asked question, glossary, help, links, and news. Some of these items are self-explanatory, and you are welcome to explore these various items at the end of this video. The one element that you will use the most while in the online classroom is content. And we will review content navigation in the next video of this series. The next category is communication. Communication contains all the elements of the course that students use to communicate with their instructor and other classmates. Under communication, you will find chat, class list, discussions, email, groups, and Wigio. Chat and discussions will be discussed in a later video in this series. The class list contains a list of all classmates, instructors, and or teaching assistants that are members of the classroom. Email will be discussed in a later video, an option one at the end of this module. Groups is a space dedicated to any group work that you may have to complete in class. This area can be used to have discussions with your group that are not public to the whole classroom. Only you, your group members, and the instructors can see the activity under groups. Lastly, Wigio. Instructors may elect to use Wigio in their classroom, however it is not necessary. If you'd like to become more familiar, there is a video at the end of this module explaining the various ins and outs of Wigio. Lastly, the final category is assessments. Assessments contains all the elements of the course that assess the student's performance within the course. First, instructors may use attendance to keep track of student participation. However, participating in the discussion board is generally how and where participation is assessed. Instructors may have students submit assignments through the Dropbox, and we will review submitted assignments in a later video. Continuing down to grades, this is where students can check for any feedback on submitted assignments. Instructors will post grades throughout the duration of the course as assignment due dates pass, so there are no surprises in the student's final grade. Links to quizzes, rubrics, and surveys will be posted here along with the results. Lastly, user progress. User progress keeps an extremely detailed account of the online learner's activity, including the amount of time spent logged in, number of visits, items completed, and various other things. It is important to remember that user progress is not a graded activity. Students do not need to worry about completing every item under user progress. Instructors and institutions use user progress to better understand online learning, collect data, and learning analytics. As you can see, there are a lot of changes in course navigation, and it is important to remember that not all instructors will design the course in the same way, meaning the layout, color, and items that first appear on your course home screen can vary from course to course.
Most of the courses in which you are enrolled will look this way. However, some instructors may elect to use a different navigation bar altogether.
Please feel free to take a few minutes and explore these various elements within the course navigation. In the next video, we will discuss how to navigate the content section of your online course.